And welcome to my channel. We will start with our session with a control system component orientation or the syllabus orientation. But before proceeding further, we must all know why we are learning this subject and is it really required in the syllabus and what is the flow in the syllabus that one should follow to learn this subject. Whenever you are learning any subject, it is having certain pre-link and post-link attached to it. For example, the control system component. When I'm saying a control system component, it is having the various components of the control industries or the industry process. Then you must have learned about the transducer sensors part and different types of transducer in this. This is a linkage that after sensing it, you are going to learn different types of the control valve, transmitter, auxiliary process controls like switches, relays, etc., alarm annunciators. So this all part will be there in the control system component. Combining these two parts, that is from transducer and CAC, or sensors, transmitters, control valve, we are forming one short loop there. These short loops are together forming one big industries like your oil and gas, like your milk industry, your cement industry, and many more, pharmaceutical industry, many more like that. So this is the actual linkage of the control system component, a very, very important subject from instrumentation engineer point of view, a very important subject for your post-graduation. If you are appearing for your GATE, you are appearing for your IES exam, this is one of the best subject to learn. So let's see what is control system component. So before proceeding further, let's please subscribe my channel first, because as I'm proceeding, I'm updating my control system component video, so you will all get to learn from it. So kindly subscribe my channel. Test 1, term test 2, and the internal exam is of total 40 marks will be there, and then you will having the final exam of 80 marks. So average of two tests and the 80 marks exam, total 100 marks paper will be there. Of course, it is having the oral and practical examination for 25 marks, 25 marks oral and 25 marks term work will be also part of this subject. Now we will see what is a course objective. What do you mean by the course objective? Course objective is why the syllabus is designed and what is the intention behind designing the syllabus. The intention is very clear. You all must understand what is a pneumatic system. You all must understand what is hydraulic system, control valve, transmitters, then the relays, switches, auxiliary panels, etc. So this is a clear cut objective of the subject. So let's see what is a course objective. Course objective is basically what you learn and earn at the end of the course. So what you are going to learn and earn from this? You are going to see what is, you are going to create a different pneumatic circuits. You are, will be able to demonstrate what is a smart transmitter, what is control valve, what are the types, then the what are the auxiliary process. You are actually going to perform certain experiment based on that. So these all part, whatever you are going to learn, you all these parts is will be you are going to demonstrate at the end of the syllabus. So let's see the first chapter, which is a very simple chapter, that is a pneumatic system. A pneumatic system, first the name, when I'm saying a pneumatic system, the air get flash front of you, right? The pneumatic system, the biggest advantage is that the air is freely available, so that this pneumatic systems are the most cheapest system available. As you can see in the diagram here, that it is having certain components, starting from the compressor to the cooler to the separator to the receiver. These all components we are going to see in detail, the study of those components we are going to do. Later we are going to see what are the symbols which is involved in building the circuit. What are these symbols basically? See, when I'm building a circuit, I need not to draw the construction diagram of each and every component. Instead of that, if I'm giving a symbological information about that component, it will be always easy for me. So based on that, we are going to design different kind of circuits. The best example, as I always giving, is the BST buses, the air conditioning buses having door open and close. So those all are the pneumatic system base. So we will see how those systems are going to work for it. The chapter number two, which we are going to see, is a hydraulic system. The media where which were using for the pneumatic system was air. Now the media is oil. Instead of the air, the oil is used. Why oil? Why not air? If you remember, the hydraulic system is having the most powerful system. So if you want to lift it, the hydraulic system is the most possible solution for it than your electrical, even than your pneumatic system. So these systems are popular when the heavy weightage is considered. So what is there in the system we are going to see? As you can see in the diagram, there is a reservoir, there is an actuator, there is a pump. Most of these systems are similar to your pneumatic one. Just the media of operation get changed there. Chapter number 3 is about the transmitter. So what is a transmitter? A simple meaning of a transmitter is it is transmitting the signal from one point to the another point. So what is the need of a transmitter? In a transducer, you learn about all the sensors. Now sensors will sense it, but it doesn't having any circuit to transmit the signal from one point to the another point. Remember, the control room is at the remote location or at the other location. Whereas if you want to transmit a signal to the control room in order to control the plant, I need a strong transmitter there. So these transmitters are normally a temperature transmitter is called as a TT, pressure transmitter is called as a PT. So depending upon the type of the process signal, they are been named. Now as you can see in the diagram there are wireless transmitter and there are head mounted transmitter. What is wireless and what is head mounted, I'll inform you. The head mounted is you are sensing here and you are transmitting here and here. There is no separate circuit attached to the sensor. Okay, this circuit of a transmitter is attached on the head of the sensor, so that is called as a head mounted transmitter. A very easy and simple transmission. 4 to 20 milliampere signal has been transmitted. Then there is a wireless transmitter. This is the era of a wireless signal. Many a time, as I said, the control room, it has other place. So if I want to transmit the signal, a simple antenna based signal or antenna is placed over the transmitter and it is transmitting the signal. A very easy to install, easy to troubleshoot the signal. So these are the most popular one. Chapter number 4 is about the control wall. This is the most important chapter, not just from your university point of view, it is also important from your placement as well as from your higher studies front of view. What we are going to learn in this chapter? We are going to learn the characteristics first of the control wall. What are the definition and terminology related to it? Then what is the characteristics of it? That is a linear, quick opening, etc. Then we are going to see the interesting part, that is what are the different types of the control walls. The control wall have the different types depending upon the plug size, that is a globe wall, butterfly wall, etc. Depending upon the application, this types is getting differ, and we are the engineers, the instrumentation engineers are the one who is going to decide which type of the control wall to use there. Later on in a final year, that is in the ISD subject, you are going to design the control wall. So basic information of the control wall or the pre-primary information of the control wall you are going to get in this subject. Then comes the next bulky chapter, that is auxiliary process control. After learning your pneumatic, hydraulic, control wall, transmitters, what are the auxiliary process control system we are going to see? So we are going to see what is alarm annunciator, what is a temperature regulator, then what is a feeder, then what is a stepper motor. You all must be aware what is a stepper motor, but we are going to see the application of a stepper motor in a pharmaceutical and different industries. So that is an auxiliary control system. Next chapter is an industrial process control system or industry control system. In this chapter, we are going to see what is RFID, that is for the transmission. RFID codes you must have seen everywhere. So we are going to see that RFID in detail about it. Then what is relays, what is switches, what is push button, these auxiliary components which is helping for my PLC, for my even the DCS system, we are going to see that in detail. This is the end of the syllabus. So there are a lot of components to learn, believe me. So this whole subject is more of diagrammatic. If you learn the diagram well, you will be able to write the information nicely about it. Let's see what are the textbooks to refer for this particular subject. Number one subject is your Andrew Parr. The Andrew Power book is most recommended for your pneumatic and hydraulic system. Then there is a C.D. Johnson, then there is a Peter Harriet, and Jones is there. These all are the recommended book for the subject. Now we will see what are the next books. These are the automatic process control system, industrial electronics, and there is a Nagarath Gopal is also available for this particular subject. This is a pneumatic phase store circuit which is freely downloaded or freely available on the website of the Festo. So you can please download this. This is a really a wonderful book or wonderful reference to use, because it is having all the circuits, how to build up the circuit, all that guidelines is given. A Festo free software for the validity of 30 to 60 days is also available, where you all can practice on that software. So please download that software also. That is really a wonderful software to use. This is a process control and optimization circuit by Bela Liptak. The whole syllabus from head to toe, the all syllabus is covered in this particular book. This is a highly recommended book by me, because as I said, this book you will be needed in your final year, and there are many topics from that final year subjects is there in that book. So keep having that habit of reading or referring the Bela Liptak. It is a wonderful book for instrumentation. Then comes the next wonderful book, that is Andrew Williams. This is most recommended, because in your final year again you are going to use this subject for the control wall. This is a most recommended book. Then there is a control wall selection and sizing book is there. This is a ISA handbook control wall is available. All these books are available in our library. So please do refer these books. There is NPTEL course recommended for this particular subject. That is the industry automation and control. This NPTEL link is given in my blog. So please go through this blog. Please type in a Google, let's learn with Adipti. You will get the first thing, that is my blog, and where the control system component is there, and NPTEL link is also given there. So please do refer the blog for the NPTEL session. Why NPTEL? The NPTEL is having the beauty that the free registration is there, so anyone can learn from the NPTEL syllabus. Only thing, if you want to appear for an examination, then you have to pay the 1,000 rupees for it, and that is very small, I believe. Okay, so please do that course. It is really wonderful. The complete structure of instrumentation, starting from your sensors to your PID controllers, everything get combined. Even the PLC and DCS systems are also part of it. So please do that course. It is highly recommended by me. As I told you that this subject is also important from your IES and GATE examination. What is IES examination? IES is basically Indian Engineering Service Examination. And GATE, you always know that graduate aptitude test examine for engineering. So this particular examination carrying a different weightage. Remember, a GATE examination is there for instrumentation engineering. That means a separate paper for instrumentation engineering is there. But since we are allied field of electrical engineering, the IAS examination, we have to appear for the electrical engineering. Don't get scared, the syllabus is just the same as what we learn in instrumentation. So what is a prerequisite for it, what is a syllabus for the GATE and IES examination, what are the papers, what is the paper pattern, and what are the answer keys, that all I kept it on my blog, Let's Learn with Dipti. So please refer the blog, all the papers, all the information is available in the blog. So please try to attend the examination. There are certain age limit for the IES exam, that is 30. So please do attempt, at least give one attempt for IES examination. This is one of the highest ranking examination in India.